So in 1905, William Pickering, a well-renowned astronomer in his time, scoured a set of photographs featuring Saturn and its moons for evidence of something quite extraordinary. On the heels of his discovery of Saturn's ninth moon, Phoebe, he was on the verge of discovering another. After searching more than 20 photographic plates, Pickering found enough evidence to publish his findings. He named this moon, the 10th one discovered around Saturn at the time, Themis. The only problem? Despite appearing on 13 photographic plates taken using Harvard University's Bruce telescope, it has not been observed or photographed by anyone since its initial discovery. I don't envy the job of astronomers. Okay, I do. But I also understand the immense challenges they face while attempting to unravel the mysteries of the universe. With the notable exception of space probes, the tool most often at their disposal is the measurement and interpretation of tiny fluctuations in light rays that have traveled at a minimum millions of miles before reaching their telescopes. Today's high-powered telescopes, of course, are precise instruments that allow us to peel away the layers of cosmic mystery laid out before us. But even so, our ability to peer into the depths of space isn't perfect. A few years ago, a possible observation of gravitational waves from the first fraction of a second of the universe turned out to be interference from cosmic dust in our own galaxy. Now imagine using technology from 100 years ago to study the stars and planets. Telescopes were quickly advancing, but many being used were in the range of what dedicated amateurs can acquire today. In Pickering's time, astrophotography was a nascent field, and the first signs of an expanding universe were yet to be detected. William Pickering himself made several important contributions to the burgeoning field of astronomical research. However, Themis cannot be counted among them. Reading Pickering's account of the discovery of Themis, it's quite easy to see why it does not exist. Pickering lays out, in plain terms, the ways in which the data he is using to describe the moon may be inaccurate. The appearance of Themis in the images is probably due to the bright glow of Saturn, leaving, as he puts it, markings and defects in the photographic plates. That is the most likely explanation for William Pickering's discovery, though it's possible to imagine other scenarios, including confusion with a dim background star or imperfections in the photographic plates themselves. I'm sure a re-examination of them could determine the cause of the mistaken discovery. It's oddly fitting that this ephemeral moon appears to have disappeared in the middle of Pickering's dataset. Pickering writes, on account of its short period, the later plates should have shown Themis in various parts of its orbit, but on none of them was it to be seen. That probably should have given him some pause about the existence of his alleged 10th moon of Saturn. But alas, these particular photographic plates were rejected and not used either way. So what should we think of Themis? It's fascinating to think about how far science has moved in the past century. We've gone from struggling to accurately detect Saturn's moons to sending an actual probe into its orbit. That alone is astounding. One fun fact is that there actually are still some unconfirmed moons of Saturn, though these, of course, are much smaller than Pickering's hypothetical moon. Themis would have been between 42 and 120 miles in diameter, while these possible moons are maybe a mile or two across. Science is becoming both more accurate and precise, but there is, as always, a margin for error. And what of William Pickering? Well, let's just say he went on to make some more important discoveries. Hope you enjoyed this video. I wanted again to do something different, and this time do a sort of non-fiction retelling of the history of astronomy.